In this lecture, we will see how to use the formula of coefficient of restitution, especially in oblique collisions like this, where a ball is striking at an angle theta normal to the wall and coefficient of restitution is given. We have to find what is the final angle alpha at which it will rebound back. So just the basics. First of all, whenever a ball strikes, whenever a sphere, ball, such kind of objects, they strike a wall and the wall is given smooth. These surfaces are smooth, both wall and the sphere. Then it may come at whatever angle, the force of impact is always normal. Until unless it is given in the question. If nothing else is given and it is said surfaces are smooth, etc., then first and foremost thing you keep in mind that you have only normal reaction and there is no horizontal reaction. So if there is no horizontal reaction, momentum is always conserved. Wherever there is no force, momentum is conserved. So one cue here is the momentum along x-axis will be conserved. And as far as vertical axis is concerned, coefficient of restitution is given, means there is some loss anyway. So when a ball strikes a wall, whatever angle, the reaction is always in normal direction, in normal plane, and if you take this as another axis, there is no force along that axis, no force along the surface of the wall until unless it is given in the problem. Now formula for coefficient of restitution for two body collision is, if take this body, this is one, this is two, if initial velocity is v1 and final velocity is v1 dash, here initial velocity is v2, final velocity v2 dash. Then coefficient of restitution is velocity of separation upon velocity of approach. So v2 dash minus v1 dash upon v1 minus v2. Be careful. If it is v2 dash minus v1 dash above, then below it has to be v1 minus v2. Just remember this cross in the suffixes. Just remember this cross. You can write it as v1 dash minus v2 dash upon v2 minus v1 also. It will also give you the same result. But if you write it other way around, then your results will be wrong. So separation divided by approach. Take all in such problems, always take an axis. This is y, this is x. Take everything positive in this direction. Now, as far as ball is concerned, what is v1? V1 is given. Another point here is that this is applied along a particular axis. So if I take y-axis, it will be E v2 dash y minus v1 dash y upon v1 y minus v2 y. So this is applied along a particular axis, x or y. Here the impact is along the y-axis. So I have to apply coefficient of restitution along y-axis. Means the reaction is only along y-axis. There is no reaction along x-axis. There is no force along x-axis. So I will not apply coefficient of restitution along x. I will apply coefficient of restitution only along that direction where there is a force. Force is acting along y. Now, what is v1y? Means initial velocity along y-axis for one is v1 cos theta. What is v2y? Is 0. v2 and v2 dash are 0. This wall is stationary. Now what is v1 dash y? v1 dash is this va. Suppose this is the velocity. And what is this velocity along y-axis? Is minus, because it is opposing. It is going above. Va cos theta is here, but my reference direction is this positive. So it is minus Va cos alpha. And what is V2 dash y? Is 0 again. Now apply this formula. So V2 dash y is 0 minus V1 dash y is plus, it will be minus minus, so it is Va cos alpha upon what is V1 y? Is V1 cos theta minus 0. So E is equal to Va cos alpha upon V1 cos theta. Means v1 upon va is equal to 1 upon e cos alpha upon cos theta. One way of writing it like this. Now apply for the horizontal component. There will be no reaction along the horizontal component, so the momentum is conserved along the horizontal component. So simply m1 v1 component along x-axis will be sine theta is equal to m1 va sine alpha. So v1 or va upon v1 will be equal to, from this formula, sine theta upon sine alpha. Put the value here in this equation, we get e is equal to sine theta upon sine alpha into cos alpha upon cos theta. So you get e tan alpha is equal to tan theta, or you get value of e is equal to, or value of tan alpha is equal to tan theta upon e, or alpha is tan inverse tan theta upon e. See, if the e is 1, your alpha and theta are same, so it rebounds in the same, with the same angle. But where the coefficient of restitution is not 1, where there is a loss of energy, this angle will change.